New Land Rover Discovery 2017, prices, specs, pictures, and full details. Latest news, experts at CAP predict class-leading residual values for Land Rover's latest rugged SUV. It looks like the all-new Land Rover Discovery is shaping up to be a sound purchase even before it goes on sale, as experts at industry body CAP are predicting the SUV to retain more of its purchase value than anything else in the class. The new Discovery is expected to retain 59% of its initial purchase price after 3 years and 36,000 miles. That's a mild improvement on the previous model, which even towards the end of its life would retain over 56% of its value. Crucially, though, it outstrips the competition by quite some margin. An Audi Q7, for example, would only retain about 46.6% of its initial purchase price after 3 years. Even the desirable Volvo XC90 only retains 54.9%. Car Finance Deals explained. Low depreciation is good news for car buyers, as it leads to improved rates on finance deals, particularly PCP agreements. The new, fifth-generation Land Rover Discovery was unveiled on the eve of the 2016 Paris Motor Show. The popular family SUV gets a new platform and revised engines, including, for the first time, a four-cylinder diesel, and promises to usher in a new level of comfort and fuel efficiency for the Land Rover Discovery batch. Paris Motor Show 2016, Preview. The UK release date for the new Discovery has been set as Spring 2017 and full pricing details have been announced, with the entry-level model available for an opening price of under £43,500. The new car will be British-built at JLR's facility at Solihull in the West Midlands. New Land Rover Discovery design and dimensions. Gary McGovern's design team at Land Rover has given the new edition of the 26-year-old model a more sophisticated, softer-edged look that moves it away from the blunt styling that's gone before and brings it into line with the Discovery Sport. This risks alienating existing long-term Discovery enthusiasts, who may consider the new car too upmarket for daily abuse like towing horse boxes and caravans. However, the latest disco leaves room in the Land Rover range for a more rugged 7-seat model that's likely to form part of the reborn Defender family, due to start arriving before the end of the decade. And in any case, Land Rover points out that the new car's towing capacity is still a hefty 3,500 kilograms. The MK5 Discovery is 4,970 millimeters long, or around 14 centimeters longer than the fourth generation car, but sits slightly lower, with a roofline of 1,846 millimeters, compared with the outgoing model's 1,912 millimeters. Bear Grylls and the world's biggest Lego set welcome the new Land Rover Discovery. Land Rover Discovery weight saving, engines and performance. The Discovery's switch to Land Rover's aluminium construction slashes around 480 kilograms from the car's weight. This, in turn, has allowed Land Rover to plumb in additional safety kit, plusher materials and greater soundproofing, as well as introducing Jaguar Land Rover's Ingenium 2.0-liter four-cylinder diesel to the lineup. The four-pot Discovery will be the cleanest model in the lineup at launch, although it seems inconceivable that the car won't benefit from some of JLR's extensive work on plug-in hybrid technology during its lifetime. Badged SD4 and paired with a ZF8-speed automatic gearbox, the 2.0-liter model will have 237 bhp and 500 Nm of torque, enough for a 0 to 60 miles per hour time of 8.0 seconds, but return 43.5 mpg and 171 g/km of CO2 emissions. That's considerably cleaner than any previous Discovery, but some way north of the likes of Audi's V6 TDI Q7 and D5 versions of the Volvo XC90. The other two engines in the UK market will be a pair of 3.0-litre V6s, a diesel called TD6, with 255 bhp/600 Nm, and a supercharged SI6 petrol with 335 bhp and 450 Nm. The more potent diesel beats its smaller brother to 60 miles per hour, 7.7 seconds, and gets close on efficiency, with fuel consumption of 39.2 mpg and 189 g/km of CO2 emissions. The petrol, meanwhile, is likely to be a tiny seller in the UK. It's the fastest model in the range, with a 0 to 60 miles per hour time of 6.9 seconds, but its combined fuel economy of 26.0 mpg and 256 g/km of CO2 emissions will make it an expensive option. Land Rover Discovery Off-Road Tech. The Discovery has a strong reputation for off-roading ability, and Land Rover claims the new edition is even more capable in poor conditions. The combination of double wishbone front suspension, an integral link at the rear and air suspension, standard across the range, means ground clearance can be extended where required, to up to 283 mm. The approach angle is up to 34 degrees, the departure angle is 30 degrees, and the car can cope with a wading depth of up to 900 mm. A two-speed transfer box is standard on all editions, allowing low-range gears for tricky off-road maneuvers. Land Rover's all-terrain progress control tech is also standard, first seen on the Evoque. It allows the driver to set a crawl speed of up to 19 miles per hour and focus on steering while the vehicle controls braking and throttle functions. Land Rover is keen to keep the Discovery's appeal as a towing vehicle, and it gets a couple of new tech features to help in this area. Advanced Tow Assist can reverse a trailer, horse box, or caravan into a space with the driver using only a rotary controller and the pedals. Trailer Light Test pulses trailer lights from within the vehicle, allowing the driver to check they're working without help from another person. Land Rover Discovery Cabin and Practicality. In the UK, the Discovery will be sold as a 7-seat model only. Its boot capacity with the third row in place is 258 liters, but with only two rows in place there's a useful 1,137 liters of storage. Folding down the third, fourth, and fifth seats increases the Discovery's load bay to an impressive 2,406 liters. Land Rover has tried to build on the Discovery's reputation for practicality by improving seating configurations and cabin storage space. The new generation gets ISOFIX child seat mounting points in the second and third rows, from SE trim upwards, and all but the front seats can be lowered and raised electrically using either the main touch screen in the dashboard or a smartphone app. The conventional buttons are also present, on the outside shoulder of the seats. In a controversial move, the existing Discovery's split tailgate has been dropped and replaced by a conventional one-piece hatchback. However, Land Rover hopes to satisfy the needs of buyers who like to sit on the boot lid with the powered inner tailgate, a 285 mm section that flips out from under the floor and is capable of supporting up to 300 kg. The fascia is dominated by the new infotainment screen, which can be as large as 10 inches, if the InControl Touch Pro system is specified. It links up smartphone apps so they can be used through the main display, and incorporates a 4G Wi-Fi hotspot for up to 8 devices. There are up to 9 USB ports on board, along with 412V charging points. Interior storage includes a hidden cubby behind the aircon controls, a center console bin that can accommodate 4 iPads, and a flush-fitting curry hook in the front passenger footwell, designed to keep shopping bags upright and secure. New Land Rover Discovery prices and specs. The Discovery's pricing will remain roughly the same. Entry-level S-Trim, which is available with the SD4 engine only, brings cruise control, air suspension, heated windscreen and door mirrors, and a powered tailgate, and costs £43,495. SE adds leather seats, heated front seats, auto headlights, satellite navigation, front and rear parking sensors, LED headlights, and interior mood lighting, and it costs from £49,495. The two higher-end trims are House and House Luxury. House costs from £56,995 and brings further features including 20IN alloys, higher-grade leather, JLR's InControl Touch Pro infotainment system, a panoramic roof, heated rear seats, and a gesture-controlled tailgate. House luxury gets even more leather in the cabin, 2-1-in alloys, electric sunroof, and rear panoramic roof, and rear seat entertainment. It costs from £62,695. SE, House, and House Luxury are all available with either the SD4, TD6 or SI6 engines. The options list will include cooling for the first two rows of seats, heating for the third row and auto access height, which lowers the car by up to 40 mm to make it easier to climb in or out. There's also a dynamic design pack, which brings a contrast roof, more aggressive front and rear bumpers, leather seats, and a sport-influenced steering wheel and pedals. Land Rover is introducing the car with a first edition, priced at £68,295 and limited to 600 TD6 powered examples in the UK. It's based on House Luxury but adds etched map detailing on the aluminium door and dashboard trim, unique badging, different exterior color choices and a more generous list of standard kit. New Land Rover Discovery vs Rivals. Land Rover Discovery SE SD4. Price £49,495. Power / torque 237 bhp / 500 Nm. Combined MPG 43.5 mpg. CO2/BIC 171 g/km/34%. Residual value after 3 years, 59%. Volvo XC90D5 inscription. Price £51,585. Power / torque 235 ps/480 Nm. Combined MPG 48.7 mpg. CO2/BIC 152 g/km/30%. Residual value after 3 years, 54.9%. Audi Q7 3.0 TDI 218 PS Quattro SE. Price £48,455. Power / torque 218 ps/500 Nm. Combined MPG 48.7 mpg. CO2/BIC 150 g/km/30%. Residual value after 3 years, 46.6%.